God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God.
Good day, everyone. Welcome back to lesson 2 in our series called Love Stories. This week we were looking at Ruth and Boaz. Now, you might have not fallen in love yet, but today we are going to look at your understanding of how love is formed. Now, everything we experience in life has got a good and a bad impact on our love and how we experience love. Now, some people think love is all about the beauty on the outside, but actually, it's the beauty on the inside that matters. Unfortunately, society's point of view doesn't always align to God's point of view of what love really is. Now, this week, we will be looking at understanding true godly love through Ruth and Boaz.
In lesson 1, we looked at the story of Abraham and Sarah. We learned true love encourages you to put your trust in God. The people we love and are close to us should encourage us to trust God. However, we should do the same for them. In the chapter leading up to where our lesson begins, we learn that Ruth has just become a young widow. Her husband, brother-in-law, and father-in-law all died within a 10-year time frame. During that time, it was difficult for a widow to survive without a male family member to cover and provide for her. Ruth set out to follow her mother-in-law Naomi back to her homeland. Although Naomi instructed her to return to her homeland and to her people, Ruth, however, was committed and faithful to her mother-in-law and chose to stay with her. Now let us think. How many young women do you know that would stay in their mother-in-law or with their mother-in-law after their husband died? Not only did Ruth stay with Naomi, but she also moved with her to a place that was completely foreign to her. Ruth showed commitment and faithfulness, both key elements when talking about true love. The verses didn't mention long hair, dazzling eyes, or a great future. Instead, we see the inner beauty of Ruth and the love she has for Naomi. God's love for us is shown in the same way. He is committed to never leaving us nor forsaking us, as it is stated in Joshua 1 verse 9. God is faithful to us. Now that is true love. I want to encourage you to go read Ruth chapter 2, verse 8 to 13. This is an interaction between Ruth and Boaz, where Ruth falls at his feet and thanks him warmly, asking, "What have I done to deserve so much kindness? I'm only a foreigner." And Boaz replied, "Yes, I know, but I also know everything you have done for your mother-in-law since the death of her husband. I've heard how you left your father and mother and your own land to live here amongst complete strangers." The images we see in the movies and on reality TV gives us a false representation of love and relationships. Ruth's character and how she carried herself were attractive to Boaz. It's what made him notice her. Fashion magazines, celebrities, athletes painting the picture that clothes, money, and other material things are the way to attract people. This is opposite of God's design for love. However, unfortunately, many people, and even Christians, get caught up and believe it.
3. If you go read Ruth chapter 3, verse 7 to 11, you can see more of these godly attributes, what we've spoken about, where actions speak a whole lot of words and how people are receiving love. In chapter 3, you can see Ruth and Boaz's relationship develop through their actions, not through their looks, but through their actions. Now that we know that Boaz fell in love with Ruth, we can see in chapter 4 how he is doing everything in his power to prove his love to her. The same attribute she showed him, for example, integrity, he is showing her towards her in the way he's dealing with his community. Boaz is showing true godly love and that he fell in love with what's Ruth's inside, her attributes, her feelings, her respect. God is showing us through this story of Ruth and Boaz what true love really looks like. We see how people that are in godly relationships treat one another. True love should always model what God wants for love, what he wants for a relationship for us. Think about your relationships that you have. Does that showcase an example of what godly relationships are? How you treat your loved ones, how you treat your friends, how you treat your parents. Even if you're not thinking about love right now, think about your experiences today and how it might affect you in the future. How your love story ends will be directly connected to how it begins. So remember, everything you expose yourself with in the media, social media, what you read, what you listen to, everything affects our thoughts, our mind, and our words. And ultimately, that will affect your godly relationships with one another. Thank you for joining us in our lesson 2 for this series. Really think about godly relationships and how you can implement what we've learned through Ruth and Boaz today. May God bless you in all your actions and thoughts this week so that you can tune in for our third lesson in the series of love stories.